The mouth is a sensitive part of the body, exposed continuously to the air we breathe and the food we eat. Germs and the toxins they produce are the enemies of teeth. On our teeth is created an invisible sticky layer, plaque. Saliva's salts harden the plaque and turn it to tartar. If this remains in our mouth for a long time, we get serious diseases such as periodontitis, which comes with pain or other symptoms and might lead to a loss of teeth in the future. The best defense against these dangers is firstly proper dental hygiene and periodical examination by our dentist. First and most important is correct brushing, which has to be done at least twice a day, morning and night, ideally after each meal. It is also absolutely necessary to brush before going to bed, since during sleep the quantity of saliva and anti-germ action is reduced. Proper brushing now. Quick brushing of 30 seconds does not clean the teeth, it just gives a sense of freshness. We need at least 2 minutes for a proper brushing, while in some cases, depending the state and structure of the denture, we might need more time. This is something our dentist will tell us. Try to feel the moves of your hand and the way the brush is placed on the teeth. Place the brush horizontally on the teeth, giving an angle of 45 degrees towards the gums. Start by doing small circular moves, trying to insert gently in between the gum and the teeth slot. Make short and quick moves on each tooth separately after you have brushed the external surface of the teeth up and down. Repeat the same on the back surface of teeth. The brush is placed vertically and not horizontally while brushing the internal surface of front teeth by moving the brush up and down. Finally, we should brush the chewing surfaces of the teeth with a back-forward movement. Pay attention to difficult areas like crooked teeth or wisdom teeth that start growing out of the gum. And finally, brushing over the tongue with a brush or the special tongue cleaning device. Brushing, even in the most proper way, cannot clean the areas in between the teeth where the teeth are connected to each other, significant areas where cavities start. These are the areas where we use dental floss or brushes, which go in between teeth, completing the brushing with the use of mouthwash, preferably alcohol-free, so that it does not burn the gum. The fluorine of the mouthwash is an extra protective shield against cavity bearers, and some of them contain anti-germ factors which prevent inflammatory diseases of the mouth. Regular visits to the dentist once or twice a year are very important, not just for a timely diagnosis and therapy of mouth diseases, but also for the right prognosis and preservation of the result. The dentist will be examining the state of our teeth, gums, and generally the mouth in detail. If necessary, he will use a series of x-rays to spot the damages of the teeth that are not obvious only with the examination. It is also necessary to heal an infection in gums while still at the beginning, before it grows into some other serious form of gum or bone disease, such as gingivitis or periodontitis. Remember that a neglected mouth can be the start of infections which can possibly threaten the general health of our body. Also, a great number of diseases often reveal the first symptoms in the mouth. Regular visits to the dentist will help to find out on time some other diseases that annoy you or will annoy you in the future. Plus, chewing food with less teeth than normal is not right, and when the situation is extensively neglected, there will appear stomach problems, having difficulties to digest food. Often, the same situation leads to anomalies of the jawbone, so the temporomandibular bone starts to perish, giving symptoms like noise, difficulty to open and close the mouth, and severe pain. Even if the dental care is perfect, following the advices of dental health, it is of a high importance to be in contact with a dentist and to visit him on a regular basis for the general examination, but also for a dental cleaning. So let's remember that for the dentist's success, it is necessary that we are his ally.